Good morning, students. So today we will continue with the linear programming problem, and today we will do the mathematical formulation of linear programming problem. Means how we formulate a linear programming problem mathematically. Okay. So here we will take an example statement problem. A manufacturer produces two types of models, M1 and M2. Capital M1 and M2. Means there is a manufacturer who produces two types of models, M1 and M2. Each M1 model requires 4 hours of grinding and 2 hours of polishing. Okay, for model M1, it requires 4 hours of grinding and 2 hours of polishing. Whereas each model M2 requires 2 hours of grinding and 5 hours of polishing. Means their polishing hours and grinding hours are different for two different models. The manufacturer has 2 grinders and 3 polishers. Each grinder works for 40 hours a week and each polisher works for 60 hours a week. Means maximum a grinder works 40 hours per week and a polisher works 60 hours per week. Profit on model M1 is rupees 3 and that on M2 is rupees 4. Okay, means by selling the model M1 and M2, the manufacturer get a profit of rupees 3 on M1 model and rupees 4 on M2 model. Whatever is produced in a week is sold in the market. Means whatever the number of models, suppose there are 10 M1 models and 5 M2 models. Whatever they can produce in a week, they sold it in the market. How should the manufacturer allocate his production capacity to the two types of models so that he may make the maximum profit in a week, also determine the maximum profit? Means, now here he have to decide how he should, means he had limited things for the manufacturer of model M1 and M2. Means he have limited hours, working hours of grinder, limited working hours for polisher, right? And you are given the profit per model, and how many time requires by model M1 and M2 for grinding and polishing is given individually. So these are all restrictions or limited things the manufacturer have. By focusing on those available sources, how he should allocate his production capacity to both the two models so that he earn the maximum profit. মানে হি কেনে কি ইউজ কৰিব হে প্ৰডাক্ট কেনি বা তার যিখিনি ৰিসোর্সেছ আছে এখিনি ইউজ কৰিব সো দ্যাট হি গেট ম্যাক্সিমাম প্ৰফিট ইন আ উইক ওকে এন্ড অলসো ইউ হ্যাভ টু ডিটারমাইন দ্য ম্যাক্সিমাম প্ৰফিট ওকে নাও লেটস সি হাউ উই সলভ ইট ওকে নাও দ্য ম্যাথমেটিক্যাল ফর্মুলেশন অফ দ্য প্রবলেম সো উই ডোন্ট নো হাউ মেনি নম্বর্স অফ মডেল M1 এন্ড M2 a manufacturer produce. So we consider, let x1 be the number of model M1 and x2 be the number of model M2, right? So we consider that x1 number of models of type M1 and X2 be the number of models of type M2. Okay, so these are the numbers of models M1 and M2. A manufacturer produced this in a week because you have to find the result for a week. So we consider that in a week, X1 be the number of models of type M1 and X2 be the number of models of type M2. Okay. Next, let Z denote its total weekly profit because you have to find the maximum profit in a week. So we consider here Z means that objective function we have studied. We consider it as Z. And how we make the objective function? suppose this is our Z. So we consider how many numbers of models for X1, M1, X1 plus X2. Why we add this? Because he should earn the profit together by selling M1 and M2 type. Now, how much profit he earned for M1? He earned rupees 3 for M1 and rupees 4 for M2. So total number, suppose he can produce 10 models of M1 type, then he earned 3 into 10, 30 for M1. And if he earned 5, if he produced 5 models of M2, then 4, 5 is 20. So he should earn 20 rupees from model M2. Total he earned 50 rupees in this way. That's why our objective function becomes 3x1 plus 4x2. Okay. Now, again in order to produce, here you are given, again in order to produce x1 number of model M1 and x2 numbers of model M2, the total number of grinding hours per week. For M1, the grinding hours is 4 hours and for M2, the grinding hours is 2 hours. Okay, so grinding hours in a week for M1 and M2, it will be 4x1 plus 2x2, because grinding hours for model M1 is 4 hours and 2 hours grinding for model M2. So total it becomes 4x1 plus x2, because our number of models for M1 type M1 is x1 and number of models for type x2 is M2 is x2. And the what is given, our each grinder works for 40 hours a week. Okay, so each grinder works 40 hours, means maximum is 40. So this will be less than equal to 40. Understood? Kya hole tu? Karon amak M1 or karne grinding hours 4 ase, M2 karne 2 hours ase. Aru logote itu hoigol duitar milai kine. Aru duita hodai less than equal to 40 hobo karon overall grinding time tu kiman diya ase in a week 40 hours. So this will become 2x1 plus x2 less than equal to 20. Okay, so this is one constraint. Subject to the constraints, ami porisilu etu. Next, polishing hours. Polishing hours in a week for M1 and M2. Polishing hours to ki hobo? Ki given asile? Polishing hours is 2 hours of polishing for M1 and M2 requires 5 hours of polishing. It means it will be 2x1 plus 5x2 and overall polishing hours in a week is 60 hours a week. So it will be less than equal to 60. This is the second constraint, right? And okay, and another, we have manufacturer cannot produce negative number of models. So X1 and X2 are positive, okay? That is the number of model M1 and number of model of M2, they are always positive. So X1 greater than equal to 0 and X2 greater than equal to 0. So these are the formulation we made from the given question. Now, overall mathematically we write it as maximize, because we have to find the maximum profit. Maximize Z equals to 3x1 plus 4x2 subject to constraint. Subject to constraints 4x1 plus 2x2 less than equal to 40, and it becomes 2x1 plus x2 less than equal to 20. This is first constraint. Then 2x1 plus 5x2, this is for grinding, this is for polishing, and lastly x1 greater than equal to 0, x2 greater than equal to 0. Okay, so this is the overall mathematical formulation of the given problem. Now you have to find x1 and x2, the value of x1 and x2. We have the method to solve this problem. So this time I am only explaining how we formulate a mathematically how we formulate a LPP problem, right? So here you have to find x1 and x2 to get the maximum value. Okay, here we also consider these are x1 greater than 0, x2 greater than, are called non-negative restrictions, right? So this is how we formulate a LPP problem. Now next we have general formulation of LPP. Okay, here we have done for two variables x1 and x2. Now how we generalize this mathematical formula? Okay, suppose we have n numbers of decision variable. Suppose we have n numbers of decision variables. Okay, and the variables are x1, x2 up to xn. Okay, to maximize or minimize an objective function. Then your objective function will be like c1 x1, because along with this decision variable we have constants c2 x2 plus dot dot up to cn xn. This is the objective function, and subject to set of constraint, set of m constraints, and the constraints are to x2 a1 and xn. It may be less than equal to, it may be greater than equal to, it may be equal to. Okay, and next so there are m equations. And what are the non-negative restrictions are, means all these variables x1, x2 decision variables are greater than or equal to 0, and x1 greater than or equal to 0, x2 greater than equal to 0, to xn greater than equal to 0. So this is the general formulation of an LPP. Means why we is called general, because here we have n number. N may be your 1, not it is 1, it is 2 or more than 2. So it will be, n will be your 2, 3, 4, anything, right? So this is all about the general formulation of LPP. Now we move to solutions of LPP means how we find the solution of these LPP, how we find the maximum, minimum and all this. So there are methods to solve linear programming problem. The first method we have, the graphical method, means we plot graph and find out the solution. This is the first time. Next we have simplex method. This is all another method to find out the linear solution of linear programming problem. But in your syllabus you only have the graphical method, so we discuss only the graphical method. What we do in graphical method, in graphical method we take the inequalities as equalities. Okay, means in graphical method we take the inequalities of constraints as equalities and then each constraint become as the equation of straight line. Okay, we get the equation of straight line. Means in constants we always have less, we may have less than equal to sign, greater than equal to sign, right? But we remove all those inequalities and we only put equal sign there, and then it becomes like a equation of a straight line, and then we solve that equation simultaneously. Means we find out, means we plot those equation of line in graph. Okay, means then we plot each line in graph. Okay, and then the region we satisfy all the inequality constraints and the non-negativity restrictions simultaneously is known as feasible regions. Okay, means the region which satisfy, it becomes more clear when we do the problems, the region which satisfies all the inequality constraints and non-negativity restrictions simultaneously that is called feasible region. Okay, that is called feasible region. That is the region, and from that feasible region we get the corner points, right? Means that feasible region has some corner, and always that feasible region lie in the first quadrant, and from there we get corner points of that feasible region. Means that feasible region may be in the shape of a triangle, square, quadrilateral, anything. Okay, so that will be in the first quadrant and have corner points. Suppose you get the feasible region of this shape. Okay, of this shape, any shape will be there. So these are called the corner points. These points we find out from the graph when we plot this, the two straight lines in the graph, we get this visible region like this, and these are called corner points. We find the value of z, the objective function, and at these corner points, and at which point the value of the objective function is maximum or minimum, that is the maximum or minimum point. Okay, that will the optimal solution of that point, that problem. And feasible solution are of two types, bounded and unbounded. Feasible solution are of two types, bounded and unbounded. Feasible region, bounded and unbounded feasible region. This is called bounded. Okay, and if you have a shape like this, this means in this way, means one side is open or any two three sides are open, that is called unbounded. Or you can say a bounded set means a bounded is that enclosed by some suitably large circle, and unbounded which cannot be enclosed by any large circle, that is called unbounded feasible region. Okay, and I said that we find the feasible region or optimum solution at any one of the corner points. So you can take it as, if an optimum means either it is maximum or minimum, optimum value of a LPP exist, then it must correspond, to one of the corner points of the feasible region. Okay, this method, graphical method, is very easy, but the main thing you have to keep in mind while writing the mathematical formulation of the given statement, at that time you should be very careful. Either means you should be very clear, that should be very clear in your mind, that whether you have to put the less than sign or greater than equal to sign in the constraints, okay, or you have to maximize or minimize your problem. Right, so if you correctly formulate the problem mathematically, then it becomes easier, because you can easily plot the graph and find out the feasible region, okay, and the maximum value or minimum value at the corner points. Okay, so this is all about for today's class. In the next class we will do the problems using graphical methods. Thank you.